Hello friends, I'm Ankita Rao and today I'm going to talk about another cryptid creature. And today's cryptid creature is the Jersey Devil. Have you heard about this creature? It's a very unique looking creature. Jersey Devil's story originates in New Jersey, USA. It looks like a combination of various animals. You know, its head is like a horse, its wings are like bat, and it stands on two legs like kangaroo, and it has a devil tail. Let's know more about this creature. In the southern New Jersey and Philadelphia folklore of the United States, the Jersey Devil, also known as the Leeds Devil, is a legendary creature said to inhabit the Pine Barrens of South Jersey. The creature is often described as a flying biped with hooves, but there are many variations. The common description is that of a bipedal kangaroo-like or wyvern-like creature with a horse or goat-like head, leathery bat-like wings, horns, small arms with clawed hands, legs with cloven hooves and a forked tail. It has been reported to move quickly and is often described as emitting a high-pitched, blood-curdling scream. So this creature's origin story is in New Jersey, Philadelphia, and it's also called as the Leeds Devil. And there are various versions of its origin story. Many people have different beliefs where the origin story came. So I will share a few of the versions of its origin story. First version. The Jersey Devil originated with a Pine Barrens resident named Jane Leeds, known as Mother Leeds. Some say Mother Leeds was supposedly a witch and the child's father was the devil himself. While some say Mother Leeds was poor and the child's father was alcoholic. The legend states that Mother Leeds had 12 children and after finding she was pregnant for the 13th time, cursed the child in frustration, saying, "Let it be the devil." In 1735, Mother Leeds was in labor on a stormy night while her friends gathered around her. Some variations of the tale say he was born a devil. Some say he immediately started to morph after his birth. Some say it took him longer to morph. Some say he only started to morph when his mother touched him for the first time. So the Jersey Devil was born to a woman named Jane Leeds or Mother Leeds. Different people have different names of his mother, but people say its mother name is Leeds. Leeds had 12 children and the Jersey Devil was her 13th child and she didn't want the child. She wanted to abort the child. So out of frustration, she said, "Let it be the devil." She wanted devil to take it away from her. She didn't want it. So she cursed him. And many people believe that due to that curse, the 13th child came out like a monster. The devil fulfilled her wish and turned her child into a monster, or the devil was born within her. Now, some people say Mother Leeds was a witch and his father was a devil, while some say Mother Leeds was a poor woman who couldn't financially bear another child. They were barely struggling and her husband was an alcoholic. So because of that, she got frustrated and said, "I don't want this child." But before, different people have come different explanation for it. Some people, during those times, people used to call women witch a lot. If any woman who is poor or mentally ill, for any reason, people don't like that woman, they will call her a witch. There is a chance some tragedy occurs, some reason people were angry at this woman and her child came out different and people started like the blaming the child, calling the child devil or something. The second version, when Mother Leeds was a girl, it is said that she fell in love with a British soldier. The British were in the area to collect the iron at the furnaces of Bastow village. In 1778, the British attacked Americans at the Battle of Chestnut Neck. The townspeople opposed the girl's love for the soldier and cursed her. Later, she gave birth to a child, the Leeds Devil, Jersey Devil. In another story, Mother Leeds was an American woman and she fell in love with a British soldier. And during those time, there was lot of conflict between Americans and British. So the townspeople got angry that she is in love with a British person, and they cursed her. And due to that curses, her child, the child which she had with the British soldier, turned into a devil. You never know, but I don't think it's a true story. Now let's know about the third version. The child of Mother Leeds was deformed and labeled a devil by the nearby townsfolk. The child may have also been sunburned, red color, like how the devil was often portrayed, which may have panicked the townsfolk into calling him the devil. Now the third version, which is the most realistic of them all, the child in a Mother Leeds must have given birth to a deformed child. You must have seen photos of some deformed kids due to genetic mutation or some kind of disease. Sometimes a person has a deformed body, it looks different than the normal body. And nowadays people understand diseases and deformities, but during those times, if anyone looked different, in a handicapped person or any kind of different kind of body, people thought that it's some different creature. Either it's a god or it's the devil. So maybe this woman gave birth to a child who looked different and had a red color skin due to sunburn, and people thought, oh my god, it's the devil. And a poor child was just a deformed one, but people labeled him as a devil. Highly plausible, very realistic. There is a chance some poor child got targeted and people started calling his mother a witch, the witch's child, the witch gave birth to a devil. This was very common during olden days, so it's a very realistic story. Now the another version 4. Mr. John Velvet of Vienna, New Jersey, entertained his children by wearing a spooky mask in October of 1830. The townspeople thought it was fun and adopted it as a yearly October tradition of putting on scary costumes and masks. This could have been a bunch of kids got together and decided to dress as a devil, featuring a mashup of different animals that New Jersey is home to, thus creating a Jersey devil to spook the townspeople for this yearly October tradition. Now another version is about a person named John Velvet. For entertainment purpose, used to wear costumes for his kids for fun, and his townspeople, people around him liked this idea of wearing costume. So it turned into an annual festival where one day in October, everyone will wear a costume, call it Halloween. Some people say this is the Halloween's origin story. I don't know for sure, but could be possible. Someone just as a joke wore this costume and people started following it, and somehow this story, some outsider created this story. Or the townspeople as a joke created this story, and the story continued as a legend. So this is also a highly realistic kind of story. I personally believe in the third and fourth version as a possibility of why Jersey Devil came into being. But let me know, what do you believe? Do you believe in Jersey Devil? Do you think it's a real creature or an imaginary creature? Now we'll know more about the eyewitness stories. Some people witnessed Jersey Devil, and we'll know their stories now. One of the first reported Jersey Devil sightings was in 1812, when Joseph Bonaparte, Napoleon's older brother, claimed he saw the Jersey Devil while hunting near his Bordentown estate. Sightings occurred and the legend grew. Fueled by animal attacks, strange footprints, and reports filled by eyewitnesses who supposedly encountered the beast. One of the oldest eyewitness story of Jersey Devil is of Joseph Bonaparte, who is Napoleon Bonaparte's brother. He saw Jersey Devil while hunting, and somehow it got traction, and one person said this, he saw, and another person also said, I also saw, kind of like a mass hysteria. People kind of, one person sees something, they get, other people get influenced, and they also start seeing things. So this is one of the earliest eyewitness stories of Jersey Devil. Another eyewitness story, sightings of 1909. During the week of January 16, 1909 through January 23, 1909, newspapers of the time published hundreds of claimed encounters with the Jersey Devil from all over the state. Among alleged encounters publicized that weeks were claimed the creature attacked and a trolley car in Haddon Heights at a social club in Camden. Police in Camden and Bristol, Pennsylvania, supposedly fired on the creature to no effect. Other reports initially concerned unidentified footprints in the snow, but soon sightings of creatures resembling the Jersey Devil were being reported through South Jersey and as far away as Delaware and West Maryland. The widespread newspaper coverage created fear throughout the Delaware Valley, prompting a number of schools to close and workers to stay home. Vigilante groups and groups of hunters roamed the pines and countrysides in the search of the devil. During this period, it is rumored that the Philadelphia Zoo posted a $10,000 reward for the creature. The offer prompted a variety of hoaxes, including a kangaroo equipped with artificial claw and bat wings. In the year 1909, newspapers had published stories about the Jersey Devil, and this created a lot of fear and paranoia among people. People started getting scared of it, and they started seeing this creature everywhere. It created a mass hysteria. One person saw something, and then it told another 10 people. 10 people told to another 10 people, and everyone started getting scared. People started seeing footprints of various animals, and due to the popularity of this creature, some people started creating hoaxes, imaginary, some people wanted publicity, so for that they made fake footprints in a snowy area, and they said, oh my god, I saw the devil over here, but this was for publicity. And one person had made a imaginary creature with multiple body parts of different organisms, different, just like in mermaid story, someone had used a monkey head and a fish tail to create a mermaid and a mermaid skeleton. Same way, someone took multiple creatures, joined them together and said, this is the Jersey Devil. So people started taking advantage of people's fear, and this created even more fear among people. And there are many more stories. One of it is, in Greenwich during December 1925, a local farmer shot an unidentified animal as it attempted to steal his chickens and then photographed the corpse. Afterward, he claimed that none of the 100 people he showed it to could identify it. On July 27, 1937, an unknown animal with red eyes seen by residents of Downingtown, Pennsylvania was compared to the Jersey Devil by reporter for the Pennsylvania Bulletin of July 28, 1937. In 1951, a group of Gibbstown, New Jersey boys claimed to have seen a monster matching the devil's description, and claims of a corpse matching the Jersey Devil's description arose in 1957. During 1960, tracks and noises heard near Mays Landing were claimed to be from the Jersey Devil. During the same year, the merchants around Camden offered a $10,000 reward for the capture of the Jersey Devil, even offering to build a private zoo to house the creature if it was captured. So during the 1900s, Jersey Devil got very popular and lot of people started seeing it everywhere. I don't know whether it's due to mass hysteria or people misidentifying it or due for publicity stunt, but for various reasons, many eyewitnesses came during the 1900s, after 1909 publicity of it, 1925, 1990s, lot of people started talking about their encounter with the Jersey Devil. They said, I saw a creature over here, I saw footprints over here, many stories came. And Jersey Devil got so popular that some people decided to give rewards to anyone who captures the Jersey Devil. Jersey Devil is not yet found. There are many more stories. I found one recent one which was published on ABC News. This story is from an article published on ABC News on 14th October 2015. David Black, a resident of the Garden State, says he captured a winged animal on camera Monday evening while on his way home from work. Black told ABC News he was driving around 6 p.m. Monday when he saw what he believed to be a llama running outside. And as he got closer, he said he pulled out his camera and snapped a photo. Then suddenly he said the creature sprouted wings and took flight from a golf course. In 2015, David Black saw the Jersey Devil and he took a video of the Jersey Devil. You can see the video in the article. I have posted a link in the description. I don't know whether it's real or he created it, but you can check out it and decide on your own whether it's a real footage or created footage. It's the most recent one which I could find, but there are many stories of Jersey Devil. It's very popular creature. Unlike other creatures, Jersey Devil has a lot of photographic evidence. Lot of people have, I saw a lot of photos and videos of the Jersey Devil, but I don't know whether these photos are real or not, and I cannot show those photos due to copyright issues, since these photos are not in public domain or the creator has not given any license to show it, so I can't show it here. But you can check out the photos and decide whether the photos and videos are real or not. I mostly am skeptical about it, I feel that people are creating this creature for publicity, or maybe someone is playing a prank to scare people, they create a fake creature to scare someone, so that's a possibility. Lot of people enjoy pranking other people, or for publicity they do it, but you never know. Maybe the David Black story or the past stories could be true. Maybe the videos and photos which are present are the real devil. Maybe there is some kind of creature who is roaming around in New Jersey area, doing something, I don't know. Let me know, what do you think? Do you believe in these stories? Do you think the evidences are real or not? And some people have come up with some explanations on why people believe in Jersey Devil. Not everyone believes in Jersey Devil. Many people are skeptical about it because human beings can't be trusted. know, human beings like supernatural stuff, so they sometimes, their imagination creates things, or you know, they do it as a joke or for publicity, or maybe they genuinely believe it, or they genuinely saw something but you know, misidentified something else. So many people have come up with explanations on what the Jersey Devil is. I will share some of the explanation with you all. According to Brian Regal, a historian of science at Keene University, folk legends concerning these historical disputes evolved through the years and ultimately resulted in the modern popular legend of the Jersey Devil during the early 20th century. Regal contends that colonial era political intrigue involving early New Jersey politicians Benjamin Franklin and Franklin's rival almanac publisher Daniel Leeds resulted in the Leeds family being described as monsters. And it was Daniel Leeds' negative description as the Leeds Devil, rather than an actual creature, that created the later legend of Jersey Devil. So, you must have heard about Benjamin Franklin. Benjamin Franklin was one of the founding fathers of United States. And he was very popular during that time. He was a very influential man. And he had a student called Titan Leeds and his father Daniel Leeds. Daniel Leeds was in opposition of Benjamin Franklin. Some reason Daniel Leeds had issues with Benjamin Franklin and he had written articles against Benjamin Franklin, and there was animosity between Franklin and Leeds. And since Franklin was the more popular one and more influential one, Daniel Leeds became the villain of the story, and people started calling him the devil. You know, Leeds is a devil, you know, kind of a bad person. But from a bad person, it is somehow the story got big, and they turned Daniel Leeds into a Jersey Devil. You know, now Jersey Devil people say, no, he's Leeds mother Leeds. So maybe, you know, this story came out like Benjamin Franklin, Daniel Leeds, you know, some other animal they saw, and a combination of something, it turned into Jersey Devil. Just like Jersey Devil is a combination of, you know, multiple animals, maybe this story is also a combination of multiple, you know, things happening. This story from this thing, story from that thing, here, and Jersey Devil story got created. So it's a, just like the animal, the story is also a hybrid kind of thing, you know, a strong possibility. And there are more explanations for it. After the 1909 appearances, the scientific community was asked for possible explanations. Reportedly, science professors from Philadelphia and experts from the Smithsonian Institution thought the devil to be a prehistoric creature from the Jurassic period. However, the Academy of Natural Sciences in Philadelphia could not locate any record of a living or dead species resembling the Jersey Devil. After the 1900 incident where, you know, lot of people started seeing the Jersey Devil, you know, science professors and scientists from the Smithsonian Institution came up with an explanation. They said that maybe the Jersey Devil is a prehistoric animal who somehow survived, and you know, it's roaming around somewhere, and you know, people are seeing the Jersey Devil, who is a dinosaur like creature. But there are no like definite proof of it, you know. Even this hypothesis is not very real, because now, there is no record of any prehistoric animal resembling the Jersey Devil. And in Loch Ness Monster, there was a plesiosaur which looks similar to Loch Ness Monster, but Jersey Devil is a creature of its own, you know, it's one of a kind. So this story is not accepted, this explanation, but it's still far more realistic than other origin stories. Now another one is, medical sociologist Robert T. Bartholomew and the author Peter Hassell cite the 1909 series of sightings and the subsequent public panic as a classic example of mass hysteria begun by a regional urban legend. some people say the Jersey Devil story is created due to mass hysteria. You know, this is a very strong possibility. Whenever people start seeing something, one person said that they saw something ghost or something strange, other people believe him and they tell it to other people, and the story becomes very big, like a dominoes effect. So this is definitely case of mass hysteria. You know, when one when we look at the eyewitness stories of any creature, you know, when one the eyewitness stories come during a certain period, you know, one person saw, immediately another person saw, another, and when this story dies down, when people are not thinking about it, then they don't see that creature anymore. And suddenly when again it gets popular, people start talking about it and more people start seeing it. So it's kind of like an imagination, you know. People kind of get influenced by other people, and when they start believing other people, they start seeing it as well. It's a psychological trick, I think, you know, hysteria created due to, you know, other people, you know, believing in other people and falling into the trap. Jeff Bruner of the Humane Society of New Jersey thinks the Sandhill Crane is the basis of New Jersey Devil stories. So Jeff Bruner and many other people said that this Jersey Devil could be the Sandhill Crane. This crane is also very large in size, a red color around its size. So some people say it could be this crane. There are some theories. The devil might be a non-native animal that someone bought over, like hammerhead bat. Hammerhead bats are native to Central Africa, and world trade was abundant in the colonial times, so such a living thing could have been brought over to the colonies and possibly escaped its owner. The hammerhead bat is a fruit bat, but with an oddly shaped head, wide lips, a wingspan of 38 inches, and nocturnal. It lacks a reptilian tail, horns, hoofs, and proper bird talons, but it could pass for a devil if settlers in an unknown land see such an unknown and bizarre looking animal. Another explanation is that it could be hammerhead bat. You know, I myself kind of believe this story. You know, because if you compare, you know, the hammerhead bat to the Jersey Devil, you know, you will see a lot of similarities between the two. You know, the hammerhead bat has a head similar to a horse. Its head is kind of like this only, and it has bat wings. So, you know, from a distance, the bat is flying, and they think that, oh my God, this is some, you know, devil-like creature, you know. People fear the unknown. Since this bat is not, you know, native to this place, so when the native people saw this bat, they thought that it could be, you know, devil or some kind of extraterrestrial or alien-like creature. So there is a possibility, you know, people saw hammerhead bat and they created this, you know, devil-like creature from it. Now resemblance is, you know, very similar. They both resemble a lot, so very high chance, you know, it could be hammerhead bat with mixed with some imagination. Since Jersey Devil is so popular, you know, people really like the supernatural stuff a lot. You know, even though people are scared of it, people really like horror things. That is why horror movies and all these things are very popular. You know, this thing is so popular. There is also an ice hockey team called Jersey Devils, and also the paranormal books and curiosity, a bookstore, you know, in Asper Park, New Jersey, holds an annual, you know, a festival celebrating New Jersey Devil and other creatures in that area. You know, it's a book club where they discuss about, you know, this creature and other creatures, supernatural creatures. And if you are into this stuff, you can go over there and check out the bookstore. I saw pictures of it on Facebook. So if you are into this, you can check out about it. It's not the Jersey Devil is not as like celebrated as the Mothman or something, na? There is a big festival, Mothman festival. Currently there is no Jersey Devil festival yet, but you never know, in future people may like want to celebrate it. Any reason for celebration is good. And this creature is also seen in many video games and the programs. Some of them are The X-Files, the Jersey Devil video game, The Wolf Among Us, 13 Child, TMNT, The Real Adventures of Johnny Quest, The Barons, Carney, A Night with the Jersey Devil, Legend Quest, and Gravity Falls. You know, various games and TV shows have used Jersey Devil's popularity, you know, since people really like him. And I hope there is a festival also. I heard there is a coaster named the Jersey Devil or something. The huge roller coaster. I don't know whether it's based on this, but most probably it's based on this. If you have seen that roller coaster, or if you have seen the Jersey Devil, please let me know about it. Please share your story. I want to know whether people who have actually encountered this, since we have not seen it, we cannot definitely agree with it, but maybe it could be true. Maybe this creature actually exists and some people have seen it. So if you have seen it, or if you know someone who has seen it, please share your story. We'll know more about this creature. Very interesting looking creature, It looks similar to a unicorn, a horse with wings, and instead of one, it has two horns. But unicorn is regarded as a very beautiful, fairy-like creature. It's maybe the angel and devil kind of creature, In cartoons, we see angel, devil. So maybe the unicorn is the angel and the Jersey Devil is the devil. opposites fighting each other. What do you think? I'm most probably would not make a video next week, or maybe next week I will make, but another week I won't. And I have decided to have a break for 1 week, since I don't make any income from YouTube, and I have to spend a lot of time for making these videos, researching it, making a painting and making the video and all takes a lot of time. So it's difficult for me to do other things, and since I don't make any money from it, I don't want to spend my entire month and all the time doing video only. So I have an Etsy shop. I sell graphics over there and I earn my living selling those things. So 1 week I am going to dedicate on my Etsy shop. I will make focus on that thing, and 3 weeks I will focus on my YouTube channel. And if you want to check out my Etsy shop, is Ankita Raut Art Store. I've put the link in the description. If you're interested in graphic designing, clip arts, digital planners, digital paper or something, I make digital stuff. So if you're interested in, please do check it out. It's affordable price. You can help me out financially. And if you want, you can also subscribe to my Patreon or donate me in PayPal if you want it. It will help me a lot. And even if you don't want to spend money, please at least subscribe to my channel. Or please tell your friends and family to subscribe. I'm trying my best to get to 1,000. It's very difficult since I get only 200 views per video, and mostly my viewers are my subscribers only. So those who are watching have already subscribed. So it's difficult to find new subscribers. YouTube algorithm is very complicated. You never know what it might like. In my past I had made videos, and some reason those videos got 1,000 plus views. I don't know why. I didn't put any effort in it, I just sat over here and talked about things, low effort videos, but some reason they got 1,000-2,000 views, and here I have to spend several hours on making this and it only gets 200. So it's the YouTube algorithm god is very difficult to please. So if you like my videos and want to support me, please subscribe to my channel and share my video with your friends and family, so I can get at least 1,000, so I can use someday monetize my video. It will take me long time to get monetized because the requirement is 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 hours of watch time, and 4,000 hours is far away from the watch time I have right now. My current watch time is 1,000 hours only, so almost 3 times amount I have to cover. four times to get a minimum requirement, so it will take me long time. So if you want to help me financially, you can please check out my Etsy shop, and if you have any issues or if you have any questions, you can talk to me on contact me on Etsy, or if you can help me by donating on Patreon or PayPal, it will mean a lot. Or you can just watch my video and like it, that's also a big deal, I get 200 views, so that each viewer is very special to me. I every second check my videos, yes, 1 view, 2, 3, it's fun. Like when you hardly get views, each view matters a lot, So thank you all for supporting me, and see you next week or maybe later. I will see. 1 week I am going to take a break. So 3 videos, I will try my best to make 3 videos a month, and 1 video, 1 week break. Or sometimes I will make a simple video, just talking or something. So 4 videos or maybe 2 videos, but I will try my best to make 3, I want to be regular with it. I don't want to be lazy and just skip over it, I want to make an effort. I cannot get success without putting any effort. So I will try to stick with 3 a month, try to get to 4 if possible, or else 3. And see you in next video. Bye.